This was a really interesting question about burns. We've covered burns before, but this was unique. They said, if a patient with more than one burn site with multiple degrees, how do I code that? Now, what will happen with second degree for both anatomical site? Do I go to a higher percent? What if there's no percent that is mentioned? What if both anatomical sites and burns with the same percent? So I kind of broke this down for us. What you need to know about that is about burns. And again, we've covered this before, but the basic thing is, according to the ICD-9 guidelines, that when you're working with burns, you need to know a few things before you start your diagnoses. The location and anatomical site of the burn, the extent and severity of the burn, the percentage of the body surface that is burnt, and the cause of the burn. And that last one involves E-codes, and I didn't really cover that. But so where's the burn at, how deep is the burn, and what percentage of the body is burned? And that goes into that rule of nines you've probably heard about. So let's cover the first question. If I have a patient with more than one burn site with multiple degrees, how do I code that? Well, it's a kind of a simple answer. If a patient has multiple burn sites, you code first the highest degree of burn. So if they have a third degree burn on their hand and a second degree burn on their chest, you're going to code the third degree burn first because it's more severe. And that's the way it is with most coding in the guidelines, is you always go with the most severe of anything that's going on. Okay? So now, what will happen with second degree burns on both anatomical sites, which makes sense. So let's say we have a second degree burn on the hand and a second degree burn on the chest. Well, then what you do is you go to body area percentage. So the if you have a second degree burn on one hand and you have a second degree burn on the chest, if you're using the rule of nines, the chest covers more of an area or has a larger degree in the percentage of nine, so the chest would be listed first. Okay, so what if there is no percent that is mentioned? What if both anatomical sites had burns with the same percent? Now, some people may say, well, you know, that's probably not going to happen. But actually, this can happen, and it has a lot to do with the documentation. You can't code something if it's not documented. And if somebody comes in and they're, you know, in the ER, and let's say they're going to just kind of ship them off to the university hospital because it's so severe, and they're, you know, the doctor's making notes and stuff, and it's not real clear, you know, you can only code with the information that you have. And so you have a couple options here. You could go with the first listed burn on the notes. And, you know, usually the doctors are trained to always go with most severe and work down. And so, you know, that is probably what I would do. And this is just me, and I don't remember where I heard this, but I always start at the top of the body and work down to the feet. You know, so there's really no right or wrong answer there, but most likely you're going to go with what's listed first by the doctor in the listing, because he will have been, his thought process was most likely list the most severe. So I put a couple little cases here just to kind of reiterate. So the first case, we got a 25-year-old presents with a second-degree burn of the right, I'm going to scroll down just a little bit. I bet Lorraine's chatting. Forearm, and first degree burn of the right index finger, and third degree burn of the abdomen. You must sequence your codes as 942.33, that's the third degree burn of the abdomen, highest degree. 943.21, second degree burn of the forearm, because there you go, that's your second degree. We're working towards first degree. 944.11 is first degree burn of the index finger. And let me tell you, it doesn't come out like some of those questions you get in textbooks and stuff. In real life, when someone's been burned, they're, you know, this happens all over, and so you're going to see multiple codes like this. Let's try a second case. A patient presents with a 10% body surface with third-degree burn of the thigh, assigned 948.11. Here, the fourth digit of the code indicates the total percentage of the body that has been burnt, and the fifth digit indicates the percentage of the body that has received third-degree burns. And I got this off a great site, and if we go down to the, especially the people on the replay club, there is, I footnoted the website, and man, they had some really good information about that. So they weren't trying to sell anything. They're just that was an informational site, and I like the way they worded those. But that's a little bit of breaking down burns when it gets a little more complicated, not just your straightforward or what we've covered before maybe in burns.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.